Hello, everyone. I'm Fatma, a machine learning engineering manager here at Capital One.
I'm Lina, a data science manager at Capital One.
Our team built a machine learning model so we can detect anomalies in critical transactions early. This helps Capital One fix issues such as if customers can't log in to their mobile app as quickly as possible and minimize the impact to customers.
However, over time, we were monitoring more than twice as many transactions as before. This added to the manual toil and the cost to maintain our ML system. Plus, our architecture didn't allow for the scalability we needed. So we start to consider if moving to serverless architecture would be the right move.
There was some skepticism whether ML models could even run in serverless infrastructure. Some didn't think it would work. The machine learning models were too large. But it was worth exploring to see if we could take some of the burden off of our team. And guess what? We did it. We shifted our ML model to serverless architecture.
It was a great move for us. We found that provisioning is simplified as you pay for service on a usage basis. Scaling is seamless and ideal for our use case. And maintenance becomes hands-off as the cloud provider handles all the housekeeping.
Moving to serverless architecture might also be a good solution for your ML model. It won't work for everyone. For example, if your model is heavy in compute and you used a large data set, say 5 years of data to train it, then this might not be a viable solution for you. But if your model is lightweight, with maybe a year or so of training data, you might also benefit from serverless.
There are challenges you may have to navigate. For one, we found running time was a huge issue for our team, with ML model training taking longer than expected. Instead of trying to cram through every single bit, we started to sample our datasets to analyze the overall meaning behind what was being processed. Just dipping into the dataset here and there saved us loads of time, as there was now far less information we had to send into the model. By sampling and optimizing the datasets, we observed reduced processing time and a spike in performance.
Memory was our second challenge. Our model was too big to fit into AWS Lambdas as is. We exceeded Lambda size limits, so we leveraged the layers. You can have up to 5 layers per function and run up to 250 megabytes in packages. You can use layers to implement each of your libraries. We uploaded each library into its own layer. Then, from the Lambda, we were able to call on the related layer to directly import the library from it. This gave us a solution that got around the issue while still allowing for smooth operations.
But we needed a secondary solution to supplement our memory issue, since we hit our limit at 5 layers each. We found dynamic library installations worked for us. For this, we compressed and uploaded the libraries, which were then downloaded into Lambda. After that, we just had to decompress and import the library contents.
We suggest you don't just start doing this everywhere, however. This solution can easily compromise your Lambda's runtime. We found that the best approach was to pick and choose which libraries we were going to compress and leave others to run normally.
So yes, while there are challenges, they can be navigated if you were thinking that serverless might be the route for your ML model.
To set yourself up for success, make sure you start from the cloud. Migrating data is far more efficient if everything is already in the correct format to share across applications. If you are currently working from your own servers, we suggest you migrate onto cloud servers before dipping into serverless. If nothing else, your DevOps crew will have a much easier time getting the various components to talk to each other in the same ecosystem.
Also, make sure you choose the right serverless option for you. Our team uses AWS Lambda, which works well for us. But there's a maximum 15 minutes runtime for functions to run. That's usually enough. But some of our code needed longer than 15 minutes to operate. We tackled this issue by deciding on a case-by-case basis whether we should use a different solution or library to get the same effect. By doing so, we actually improved our ML model. Since we had to work to find faster solutions that eventually ran in less time overall.
Now, that worked for us, but we recommend that you review what options your cloud provider offers. You should be able to find all that documentation on your options online. Take your time with this stage, weigh the pros and cons of each package they offer, and then choose the path accordingly.
Hopefully, our experience serves as guidance that will help you in deciding if and how to move your ML model to serverless.
As you continue on your own course towards a serverless model, stay flexible and enjoy discovering new possibilities with serverless ML models.
We wish you the best of luck and thank you for joining us today.
Oh, and for more information, check out our blog on capitalone.com/tech.